Hi all, we are starting the workshop very soon. I'm just admitting all of them who are waiting in the waiting room. And we have this art of integration. The integration itself is a word which tells about the subject integration, of course. And here we're talking about hands-on activities which could be absolutely be done at home with your moms. And of course, educators can use it. And these kind of DIY or the hands-on activities are not available on the internet anywhere. So happy watching Aparupa conducting this. Let me introduce Ms. Aparupa. Hello. I think Nandini, you have to remove this. Hello, Nandini, I think you have to remove this for some time, this DIY thing, I mean this thing, so that I can see Aparupa, because I'm introducing Aparupa. So Miss Aparupa is going to conduct this workshop for you, and I can't see Aparupa anywhere.
Huh? I'm very much there, ma'am.
Okay. Let me admit the other people who are there waiting in the room. Okay, this workshop is being conducted by Ms. Aparupa. She is the curriculum head as well as the primary head of the Green School Bangalore. And it's a very interesting and exciting workshop which you'll be watching. The videos will be shown, of course, and will be a live thing which you can do it along with whatever she's telling you to do. And this is very interesting because this is subject related as well as it's fun. And a lot of take home, of course. So Manju Chakravarti has Abraham presented here, the Bangalore School also was there along with us. And of course, Nandini is here to help out Aparupa, and other people also have helped Ms. Aparupa. There's a whole big team with her. So all the best, Ms. Aparupa, and over to her.
Yeah. Hi and good evening all. I hope you're as excited as I am to start with day one of our workshop. But before we begin, here is something that I want you all to see, and then we will build on that. Are we ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Requesting Nandini to share her screen.
Now, Nandini, you can share the screen.
Have a look at this small video, and it's pretty much self-explanatory, but I would want you all to have a look at it. So this is the workshop all about, that, you know, we are going to integrate things together, and then what are we going to achieve? This is a very small clip. If you can see, it's very self-explanatory. There is this lady, and they are from the, you know, lower income background, who sells pineapples or fruits and earns the mother and the child. And the mom always thinks, you know, how am I going to carry this forward, or, you know, how am I going to teach her? Teach. Please remember the word teach. How am I going to teach her so that she can, you know, carry this legacy forward? Because that's their only earning. So here she is. Watches her mom do this activity every day of peeling the pineapple. But one fine day, if you would have seen, she sees these ice cream people selling ice cream. She cuts it, puts in a stick, and moves it into a ice box, and comes out with this interesting piece of pineapple popsicle. Nobody taught her. Please remember that. Nobody taught her. It was learning by looking at her environment, putting her critical thinking, her 8 multiple intelligence into use, and she came out with something really beautiful. And we all
have pineapple.
And then her mom teaches her the second part of how to sell that in the market. So she goes and studies that too. Can you see? She's going and observing how they are selling it. And then she strategizes of how she will market her product. They don't have enough resources. So just see what she's doing. She has done everything handmade and she is there on her own. A very innovative thing, which was not in the market. And that's how it is. And in the end, it shows that, you know, she earns a scholarship with this innovative idea of hers. And then she studies further to complete her degree. So can you see that? I mean, it is a very interesting piece of thing where all of us have that capacity to put things that are simple resources available with us, but it's just that we have to put our thoughts together and come out with something that is absolutely there. See her, that's her. Okay, so keeping this in mind, we will start today's workshop. Are we all ready? Give me a thumbs up. I can't see the videos, ma'am. I need to be interactive with them. So we're going to mess around with everybody. As I said, mess stands
can you,
for...
Can you, can, 1 minute, Aparupa. Can you all switch on your videos, please? So it'll be more interactive with Miss Aparupa. Don't switch on your audio. Just switch on your videos, all of you. It's a request. Thank you.
Ma'am, there's a power-related issue, so I'm just giving a heads up. So between the power toggle, that could be a 1 to 2 minutes of snap. If the connectivity snaps, it will be just a 1 to 2 minutes thing. So stay online. Do not disconnect. We'll be back. So STEM is all about, can I have this sidebar going? So STEM is all about what and how about the things. But STEAM that we call includes why and by whom things are done. So putting those in mind, we have created the mess using our multiple intelligence. We have had a session on multiple intelligence. We have 9 of them. Let's explore them, enjoy them using the simple resources with the safety aspects, and let's get stress-free. So let's begin, Nandini ma'am. Next slide, please. So today we are just going to do it with Apple. We have a lot of educators, we have parents, and you know, for parents also, our children are still students. We are ourselves students, even though, you know, I'm conducting this workshop, I am also a student from some aspects. So if our students are only able to recognize a solo red apple, then the question is, do they really know what an apple is? Do we know what we can do with this one apple? Today, the entire workshop will be built around an apple, right from a toddler to adults. All of us can do a lot of interesting things with this apple. I know a lot of you are already pondering upon the ideas, what and all we can do. But given in a normal scenario, we normally don't stretch our brains to think further than just viewing an apple as an apple. Okay. So, Nandini ma'am, are we ready?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll just quickly show you what a toddler, which is about 2 to 3 years, who can barely actually start to run and, you know, balance themselves. Vocabulary, let's forget, you know, they just can't talk. They are, you know, picking up things, whatever they are seeing. So what is very strong for them? They're working on their gross motors, working on their visual, their kinesthetic skills. So all of that is what we are going to achieve by just using the apple. Can we have the videos on and let the parents see what we can do with an apple? Okay, here we go. These are dedicated to all the 2 to 3 year olds. Are you all able to see me on the video?
Yes or no?
Yes.
You can switch on your audio and say that yes or no.
Yes, of course we are. Thank you.
Okay. So we are beginning with the activity. So we have an apple. Now I know we can do a lot of things. Now you can see over here, you can have these piece of tongs, and these are bigger apples. So obviously 2 to 3 year olds don't have the grip to hold such big apples. Okay, you can also try. I'm sure you will also fumble when you try to hold it with a tong. But you get these Shimla apples, which are small. You can try with that. But today what we are going to do is very simple. You are going to give them, can you see these bowls of apple? So is it a solo red apple? No, it's not solo red apple. Just see the variety of apples. So we introduce them to the word apple, but we never let them explore how many kinds are there, what shape these can be, the touch and feel of it. Yes. So when you touch, you're doing the sensory activity. Visually, you're showing them the different colors and the structure. And all that you have to do, all children love water. Just take one and throw it. Take one and throw it. Let it splash water, no problem, and throw it. And they're going to put their head down, as you can see it over there, to see actually if the apple had gone underneath or they are just bouncing up. In the bargain, they also see their image. Now that's very interesting because they keep doing that. That's one of the activity. The other activity could be, you just take these apples and cut them. All apples with different colors are finally white from inside, as Preeti Vikram had mentioned. So when you cut, as magic, all of them will turn out to be white, but outside they're all different colors. We're not going to ask you to use any paint. You can just use turmeric, you know, a little bit of turmeric powder in the water, create some color, put it and let it roll on the papers or cloth. We right now do not have a ball crayon for the gross motor grip, but when you cut it, it gives you that grip. So they can grip it and do that thing. You're working on their eye to hand coordination and the gross motor, keeping in mind the skill development. And you're giving them a bigger place to do that, because we don't have a doodling sheet. So the best thing is to give it over there. Or you spray some rava, put some maida, and let them make some imprints on that. All of that helps. So, and they can do it for hours. Trust me, they can do it for hours together. So these are some of the interesting activities which you can do with the toddler. The next one we will see is for the pre-K. I think let's do it. Let's do it. Does everybody, whoever has apple of any color, just get apple and get some toothpicks? We're going to create coronavirus out of apple. Can we do that fast? Manju ma'am, can you get the counting on 10, 9, the descending order? 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Are you all ready?
1 and 0. Excellent. I have an apple. Touch it. Make them touch and feel it. Okay. Can you see this? Everybody can see it?
Yes, we can see now.
Okay. Now pick up. So while you're doing this, you can introduce the phonics. What sound apple makes. Ah, ah, apple. You can sing that song. And also have some more, two more objects which make the same sound along with that. Okay. Now, every toothpick that is there, you are supposed to just, so the child holds it. Can you see my grip here? So see the grip here and see the grip here. This is a pincer grip and this is the gross motor, because they are transitioning from the toddler to the nursery. The grip and the grip. We are introducing the pincer grip. All they have to do is, again, the visual to hand and one inside. So I have put one. Next one is two. And I can have a picture of the coronavirus. It pretty much looks like this. And then I have a three and four. Now, some of them might just leave it this way because their grips are not strong. As parents, as teachers, you all will come to know if they're not able to go through. This will also give you an idea about the flesh of the apple, you know. And four, and you can go on, you know, till 10, as we do value association. You can just associate value association, creating coronavirus, teaching literacy, all of it, and your soft skills getting developed at the same time. Along with this, some of our teachers and parents can also extend it to this activity. How we can describe apples? Obviously, they can't read, so we have to kind of, you know, prompt them. How can we describe apples? So you have apples. Now somebody will come up with red, green, yellow. What kind of shape? Somebody will say round. Somebody might say oval. Those are on the higher thinking grade. Now, is it big, small, medium? Right? Is it crunchy or is it soft? Is it hard or is it smooth? Now, what we do? Let's have a bite of this juicy red apple. You have already given the answer. Juicy red apple. Now, we are not allowed the child to explore. Is it juicy? Is it red? Obviously, it's an apple because we have already told it's an apple and it's not an orange. So let them bite into it and come up and say, it is very juicy. It is very crunchy. Oh my God, I don't like this skin. Some of them will spit it out. So that gives you the sensory, you know, assessment of a child, not prompting. So you're not teaching. They are learning by self-exploration. Okay. And at the end of it, we can make something like a apple sauce, which could be sweet, or we can dip this into something like a, you know, salt, you know, vinegar, sour, and let them have it with the bite of the apple. Not just take and say, let me see if you have the sensory skills for salt, if you have the sensory skills for sugar, but let's do it with something nice. So some more of these activities, see, finding things in Google, as ma'am said, is there. Improvising it to your customizing it to your needs and to the level at which you can make it more interesting is up to us. So these are some interesting activities with pre-K, the nursery children, all of them integrated in here. Okay, ma'am. Now we move to the next level. That's the K1, our LKG. They have become bigger. Vocabulary has increased. So we have something more exciting. I don't know how many of you all have read this book by Dr. Seuss called 10 Apples Upon Top. Manju ma'am, have you read it?
Yes, Aprupa.
You have read? Can you tell something about it? I mean, I know it's very interesting, but let's hear it from you while we show you how to do this activity.
Okay, so how do you want me to start for it?
So, you know, Dr. Seuss, all of us know, is a very interesting author for children. He comes up with all these, you know, wonderful things, and there are catches, you know, when I mean catch, there is a twist in the story. And this particular book, if you have not read, is available on Amazon. You can, you know, read it from there. It hints at literacy, numeracy, both of them. Look at this activity. Now, on the face value, it looks very simple. But you also try it. All the parents try it, doing it with the bigger apples. What and all it can achieve. Here I have simple maida. So this is maida. I have put little cinnamon powder to give it that smell and the texture. So, you know, again, the feel is there. And which will act as a dough for me. Right? So I can do several things with this. I can build patterns. I can tell them I need a green, two red, one green, or anything. I can put some alphabets on it, just stick on and say, I need an A and then two, you know, something that makes a k sound. And then maybe I will require a t sound. And then again, continue with the series. Or as simple as stacking 10. Can you see 10 apples up on top? It's pretty difficult. Try doing it. We will all try it together. I know you all don't have the maida. But it all depends on how you're making this dough. Okay. If it's going to be thick, thin, again, thick, thin, you're using your hands. So the sensorial touch is there. You're putting it as a base. So it should stick out there. You already have a stem here. So they need to figure out whether, you know, you can put it on the stem and it will stick, or it's going to create a small kind of a perforation here. But if that's the case, they will use their critical thinking and they might ask you to remove the stem, or some of them will try to put more of it here and then maybe stack a green one. And then goes the tower. the way we instruct. So what have you done here? You're enhancing their listening skills. They're listening to you carefully. They are now processing in their brain a little bit of more than one-on-one instruction to multiple instruction, because you're giving two at a time, you know, because you're giving two patterns, or one apple, two green, one. So you're going a little fast. You are also increasing some vocabulary over here, because you can, Nandini ma'am, if you can just put the, you know, on prepositions. Where is the apple? The green apple is on top of the red apple. The red apple is below the green apple. So the place on below. Literacy. I'm just giving you examples. These are all there, but what have you done with it is very important. Where have you taken? Have you just copied and pasted it, or you have gone beyond that is the question. And then there is something very interesting. The last slide, next one. You can also improvise this K1 thing, saying what is inside an apple. Here is an apple. What do you think is inside an apple? I mean, even you can think what is inside an apple. I'm sure you can just come up with 5 things that are inside that apple. But trust me, there are much more to do things with that inside of that apple. We will touch upon this if there is time, of what and all can be done with the inside of the apple. But you can leave it with a thought that, children, what could be inside the apple? Do you think a green apple would have...
Aprupa, your video has stopped. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Aprupa.
This is a power toggler. She already mentioned it.
She mentioned it. Parents, kindly bear with us. Meanwhile, we have got a group here, chat group. And you can put up your questions here in the Zoom group chat. And you can also, we are live on Facebook. And you can also put your comments on the Facebook. And we will try to answer your questions after Aprupa finishes her workshop. I'm sure that you're all enjoying so far, and you've understood how to, you know, teach the children a very fun way, and through activities. And it's all can be procured at home, and you can use it for the children, and you can make the activities fun. And it also can integrate literacy, numeracy, and EVS. So that's the whole point. So
yeah, but I told you there'll be a power issue. Before we talk to the, you know, the Chen said to us, yes. So we are back. Now we are moving to the K2, our smartest of all in the preschooler. So Nandini is starting with this, and the degree of difficulty only increases. Oh my God, look at that. What do we have? Fractions. Fractions. Nandini ma'am, can you just take over and just show, you know? So we can go with a whole apple, and then,
and when you cut the apple
into, ma'am, we can't see Nandini ma'am. Yeah, it's fine now.
Okay, now we have half. Yes, and now with this half apple we are going to again slice it into. So can you all count how many parts we have? Half, 1/4. Now the same apple, the piece, if I slice it again, now I'm going to have, with one apple, I will have 8 parts of it. So this is how we will teach fraction for K2.
Okay, then there's something interesting. Once you've made the parts, you can make further pieces and ask them to join back to make the whole apple again. You're working again on their grips. And you're working on their critical thinking, because you would have jumbled all the pieces, and this can act as a jigsaw puzzle to put them back again. So that's a very interesting thing to do. You know, that's how the Tanagrams also work, where you have different kinds of things and you put together to make, you know, a puzzle fit in together. So you can just use a simple apple to do that. Okay. You can introduce something like describing words for an apple. Give that apple and ask them to come up with words. So, you know, everybody will come up with their little thinking hat on, and you can put it up on your wherever, you know, you can pin it up, you can write it down, whatever way. The ones who are not able to, you know, verbally say, they could also, you know, look, I'm talking about the speech delay or, you know, the learning difficulty children. They are much good with the visual part of it. So if you can put it up on the screen with some kind of a picture, they will be able to pinpoint. Children with, you know, the learning curve on the lower, this little bit of autistic children. So I'm looking at the special needs also over here. Okay. What else, ma'am, we can do? Oh my God, addition and subtraction. Can you believe that? Now, as I told, subtraction is very negative. If I take away something, even from Usha ma'am, I'm sure she's not going to be happy about it. Will you be happy, Usha ma'am? I'm sure you won't.
Something no.
Like, yes. So imagine our children. You give them something and then you say, hello, now give me two of that. Why would they give? They will not. So teaching subtraction is really difficult and we know it. We all know it as teachers and educators. Even as parents, taking away something from someone is really bad. So you can do this with the apple where, you know, you can just do a pictorial depiction where you give it to your friend. Okay, I give it to Nandini ma'am. And then I tell Nandini ma'am, you give me one whole apple. So she gives me one whole green apple. When I tell her, give me half an apple, obviously she would just cut it and she would give me half an apple. Here the parental guidance of the teacher is required because there is cutting that is involved. But that would have been done and given beforehand. So along with this, we had done the stacking. You can use that same stacking to teach them the place value of tens and ones instead of the beads and abacus. You can use the same thing. And you can also have the ascending and the descending order in the similar manner. And use like dominoes. So if you don't have dominoes, you can use all of it. Okay, ma'am. I think you looked at the preschool. I'm sure there are primary who are waiting and must be thinking, what will we do with an apple? I mean, they have so much to do. I don't think we have anything to do with apples here, but you all have. Okay. You have apple science. Give them
just 1 second. Just 1 second, Aprupa. After kindergarten, you can take some questions from the parents.
Yes, they have, ma'am.
Primary. Yeah.
Pardon?
Do you have any questions for parents for the kindergarten before we move on to the primary? Okay, you continue, Aprupa.
Give me that piece of apple, Nandini ma'am. So we all know that when we cut the apple, it turns brown. All of us know. Right? So when I said what is inside an apple, this is also inside an apple. The minute you cut, within 5 to 10 minutes, it will turn brown. But as parents, as educators, we just show, you know, a beautiful science experiment, it turning brown. But let the children explore and give them their ideas as to why it turns brown. What is it that could make it turn brown? I'm talking about the higher grades also. So when you go up the ladder from grade one upwards, their critical thinking is very important here. Okay, if it turns brown, is there anything that I can do to get back its original color? We don't do that. We just say, okay, let's put it in soda, let's put it in vinegar, let's put it in milk, let's put it in water and see what happens. You've given the answer over there. You have not allowed them to explore by themselves that if I have to get this color back, can I put it in different things and see? Some of them would just take a brush and a toothpaste and start cleaning it also. Take out that brown color. It's as simple as that. So, you know, that gives you a way to think what are their critical strengths because now they are progressing and that inquiry-based learning becomes very important in the primary year to middle school. Okay, ma'am, what else?
Hello. I think that your internet is a little slow.
No, ma'am, we are changing the...
This. Okay, okay.
Okay.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. Okay. Tower. Balancing that apple on a tower. Or cutting these apples into small bits of pieces and then designing it together to build a tower. We are heading towards something called STEAM, which was the beginning of my entire session. Now, if you all have it, you all can just do it with me. Cut that apple into small pieces. If you have toothpicks, try to connect them together and get a structure. You can build a hexagon. See, this is as simple as this, but this can get as complicated as the grades increase. A sixth grader will not achieve this. They will achieve it much more. Okay, this is as simple as that, but you can just keep connecting and making it more complex. But it has to be stable because it has to stay. So whatever you do, the base gets stronger and you keep building it. So you can try this activity back home. Now, there is something very interesting we are going to do with y'all. This is the literacy part of it. You can put it up for grade one, grade two, where you can just write properties of an apple. We never do properties of an apple. We do properties of, you know, all those what is a property of a iron? What is a property of a steel? You know, all these things. But have you ever studied the property of an apple? Have you ever studied the life cycle of an apple? I'm sure none of them know what is the climate needed, what is the soil needed. In fact, you all don't even know what is the size of the apple tree. We just say apple grows on a tree. Which tree? Big, small, medium. So all of that becomes very important in your quest for learning. You can give them a problem of the day because they can read now. And of course, with the word apple ending in L-E or perhaps even P-L-E, they need to figure out some few more words. So all of that can be done as a literacy activity with your kids, just with an apple. Okay, are we ready for an apple teaser time? Because it is tea time or the coffee time, all of us on a break. Let's have an apple teaser time. What is it? The apple teaser is very simple. It's completely on STEM. We want you to design an apple boat. So you have to put your science, engineering, technology, art, and mathematics, all of it together, and design a paper boat which would float on a bowl of water. It could be anything. We really don't know which will make it float and which will make it, you know, move to a longer distance. Children of fourth, fifth, sixth grade can also attach a small battery with a circuit to propel it through. But it all depends upon, now you might be thinking, how is a maths going to be done with this, right? Now, a maths is very important because it depends upon how you're cutting that apple. Is it, you know, the base is thick, so the volume that it is going to take, you know how the ships move, right? So that is the mathematics involved over there. You know, whether it is a thin or the base is this. So first you need to give this sheet and they need to design it. So if you have a paper, you can quickly design. We can give you about, ma'am, do we have 10 minutes for this designing of any apple boat?
Yes.
Yeah, so we can do that for about 5-10 minutes as a break and they can all put it up on their screen.
Yes, you can do that. Quickly, you can do that.
All of you can do it. I mean, even the teachers, the adults who all are sitting along with their children, who knows that your kids are far more better designer than you are? Your apple boat might not move.
Properly. And whoever does the best, we'll put it up on our Facebook.
Absolutely, ma'am. Yes. Absolutely. In fact, even the tower, ma'am. That designing tower that I said.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
So we are getting things ready. We're not going to show you, but we are going to show you different varieties of the apple boat. We are doing it with you, but we're not going to show you. So anybody who has an apple can help it. Please remember, you are just designing it. We don't want the working model right now. Just draw it and show it to us. And maybe later on you can take a video, keeping that design in mind, and do it. And those are your helping, hand questions. So this is what we call STEAM. Your science, your engineering, your technology, your art and mathematics all integrated together with all your subjects in there, creating something wonderful out of it and engaging them and engaging yourself. So we are going beyond just apple and its wedges. Oh my God, Nandini ma'am is ready with different designs of apple here. Are we ready, ma'am? Can you see anyone ready with anything?
Can you just put it up if you are ready? Can you just put it up and show it to us? I don't think so. Anybody is making anything. Are you making?
You're ready? Okay. Trust me, we are also doing it with you. So please don't think that we have, you know, already done it and we are just showcasing it. Only thing we are not showing you, because then your critical thinking just hampers there.
I want moms and dads to be proactive with their children. Please.
Yes, yes, ma'am, along with their kids. I want to see what they are thinking in terms of designing an apple boat.
Do you think you need some more time? You can unmute and talk.
Yep. Or you can put a thumbs up. I hope the teachers are also doing this. If they have an apple, otherwise later on. Just cut a slice from Nandini ma'am. I want them to see how inside of an apple looks, because we only talk about stars. Okay. In the meanwhile, Manju ma'am, can we have some brain teasers with apple?
Sure, we can have that. I'll just share the screen.
Yeah.
Can I share the screen?
Yes, please go on.
Do you require Nandini ma'am to move this, or she can share separately, ma'am?
I think she has to move.
I'll move out, ma'am. She can.
Aprupa, you can keep your video on.
On?
Okay. I said you can keep your video on.
Yes. Okay. So can you see some interesting apple idioms that we call? Idioms?
Can you make it as a full screen, Manju? The side one, you can close it. It'll become much more clearer. Just make the apple idioms stand out.
So the apple idioms are nothing but using apple in your idioms. Now, idioms are something that are introduced in your secondary level of English. The figure of speech, the idioms become an integral part of our studies. But that's what I said, and apple can do wonders.
How many of you know what is a proverb?
Idioms.
Yes, you can answer.
Proverbs, idioms, and figure.
By unmuting, you can answer. How many of you know what is a proverb? So idiom is something like a proverb for the little babies out there who are watching.
Yes.
Yes, we use idioms like as easy as an apple pie. It's like a comparison. Or polish the apple. These are all idioms.
Yes, which is to flatter someone. A bad apple means a bad person. Okay. Oh, you upset my apple cart, which means you planned something and the entire thing or a surprise and everything was just ruined. And this is a very famous one, you're an apple of my eye. Yes, that you are someone that you like so much, that you're the apple of the eye. So can you, that's what I said, ma'am, there's a lot of things hidden inside that apple, like an apple idiom. So you can, you know, things can just flow out. Now, we teach stars, isn't it, Usha ma'am? But we draw stars, we show stars. We do so many things to do stars. The star is right in here. If you cut the apple in the round shape. Can you see the star?
Aprupa, you can make an apple jam. You can make apple jam.
Yes, we will come to that. Just see the star that it has formed here. You don't have to go anywhere, just look at it. You can talk about this many seeds and the few seed concept also over here. Okay, the next one, there is something very interesting after this, Manju ma'am, which I want you to put up. This is very interesting, ma'am. This is for the parents. The second page. I don't know how many of you all have ever come across this statement, which is going to come up now. Okay,
The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. That means a person grows up to be very similar to his or her parents in behavior or physical characteristics. Children are very similar to their parents because of parents' biology. We cannot have that, and genetics involved. But I'm talking about the other emotional quotient, the behavior. So please don't come up and say, how did my child become like this? Maybe there is a contribution from all of us. The teacher, whom they imitate, the parent, whom they imitate. So the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. It falls very close to the tree. It doesn't, right, you know, travels a lot. It just falls there. That's what it means. And that's an explanation over there. So something as a take-home message for all the parents, educators, and all of us. Keep that in mind. Are we done, ma'am, with the designing? Thank you, Manju ma'am. Thank you so much.
Welcome, Apruta.
Okay, are we done? No one? Ma'am, I'll go ahead with us.
No, just no, mine. There is a, just now Priyanka Singh is asking, where can we send this?
Oh, that ma'am will tell you.
I said, put it up on the screen.
Yes, you can. So we have a bowl of water, very small. And this is our first apple boat with a sail. Can you see that? Okay. A small apple with a sail. Okay, we have attached this for aesthetics. Of course, teaching the wind propelling, and the base is small. Let's see if it is going to go in and float. No, it sank. So this was not the right model. So it's not the right model, unfortunately. Okay, let's try the next one. So failures are a part of this game because we are exploring. Okay, we are making our brains think of what is going to work best. So don't think, you know, this was done on purpose. Seriously, it failed. So here goes the second one. Okay, this was better than that, but it still sank. We are on Titanic. This is without a sail. Okay, this one is doing good. It is moving. So maybe the round shape is better than the wedges. Now this one is with a sail. This is heavy, so it went down. So if you put too many things on that, it's not going to stay. And obviously the last one, which we had put, it does stay. You can keep trying. You can keep trying different varieties of it, and it's going to do wonderful. But let them try it. Do not prompt them to do it. Can you see how many failures we have had? Every time you have a failure, they will come up and they will try the next design. Design A versus design B. And what works, and then you can beautify it. Do not put, so that means you do not put a lot of things on it, otherwise that is going to sink, right? Even in your real life. Okay. We're going to come to a close of this session. And
I think I have Priyanka who wants to talk. Yes, okay. You can unmute and talk.
Okay, so hi, ma'am. As you said, after listening this activity,
I want to see you, Priyanka, ma'am.
Priyanka, switch on your video. Okay.
All right, I'll do that. Thank you. Just give me a minute, please. Hi.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, so after listening, you know, this interesting activity, it was my son who did this, and unfortunately, he was not at all, you know, he didn't want to waste the time because he thought that it's going to be displayed or some award and all that he heard. So what he did was one sea cell, you know, and apple on top of that toothpick, and he fixed it. He tried
very
to
good. Excellent.
In the water. Somehow it was floating, and the next was like, you know, the experiment is successful and it was finished, you know.
Can we see
the apple? Never mind. So if there are no failures, Priyanka ma'am, there is no success.
So I'm actually thankful to you that, you know, you have saved my time. I don't have to ask him to eat again because this interesting activity is so thin, you know.
No problem.
So you could tell you. Even ma'am failed three times and she was successful in the last two. After all,
can we see the apple board picture, please?
Ma'am, actually, yes, please. I have.
Ma'am, we are coming on the screen.
So you want me to share
yes.
it? I don't know.
Yes.
You know, I can't share because I'm not.
Or Priyanka, ma'am, if you have taken a small video of the whole mm-hmm. activity, it'll be mm-hmm. great to see it happen and then, you know.
I'll do it and I will send it to you because anyway, awesome. You always asked us to share, so I'll do that.
Yes, yes,
Priyanka
please.
Singh is the head of the ECC branch sure, of the Bangalore that. School. And it's nice to see you very involved along with Aprupa. So I hope that you all enjoy yes. whatever activities has okay. been given to you. Yes, Ms. Aprupa, over to you.
So ma'am, let me just, I'm going to wind up this session and it's going to be in another interesting manner. So Nandini ma'am, if you can just show them some of the designs of the apple boat, which can work. Interesting apple boats, which can work. Yeah, so you can try this later and send us small videos and we can put it up on the Facebook as ma'am said. And let's mess around. So the mess that we created, spilling water, cutting things, trying out variety of things together, the maida, the stacking. Oh my God, it's a whole lot of a mess. But what was mess? It was your multiple intelligence, which your energy, lot of energy, enthusiasm, your simple resources. And I hope you all are stress-free. I didn't stress you all out. So now let's put all this mess together in its literal sense, mess, and create something beautiful. I'm going to leave you with this message that now you can accumulate all of this and give us something beautiful. What are those beautiful things we can do now? We have half-cut apples, little bit of dough here and there, you know, the sailboat, and you must be thinking, oh my God, I have to chuck all of these, you know, costly apples into the bin. No, you don't have to. Let's see what you can do. You can create an apple crumble, which is very simple. You can find these recipes all over. It could be barbecued. All those have a barbecue. You can use, put it on a tawa and cover it. And you can have it wonderfully done. You know, and it's, believe me, it's very tasty. Because the juice that oozes out and when it steams is really good for health. Okay. Next one that you can do is make a bird feeder with an apple. You can cut that apple, scoop it out. You can use the scoop for something else in making an apple custard or anything you would want to. And put some water, put some seed, tie and put it in your garden if you have or near your window for birds. Because nowadays birds are coming in because of the COVID. You know, you have a lot of them coming. So beautiful bird feeder connected to the nature using just an apple. And I will leave you with one thought. Do green apples give you green juice? Red apple give you red juice? Pink apple give you pink juice?
And the more that parents
understand. So that's the thought I leave you with. Do try it at home. If the green apple gives you green juice, red apple gives you red juice, pink apple gives you pink juice, and yellow apple gives you yellow juice. Do the different apples give you different color of the juice with texture and its, you know, consistency? Try that out. Send in your answers to Usha ma'am and she'll be posting it on Facebook. I hope you all enjoyed the session and we'll be back on Saturday. Thursday, we'll take a break. Saturday, we'll be back with something interesting. Let's be on suspense and clear our mess and get ready for the next mess and steam it out with our second workshop. Would like to thank Nandini ma'am.
I must thank Nandini.
Out. Yes.
For both.
Thank you so very much. Hope you enjoyed.
Just 1 second, Aparupa.
Yes, ma'am.
Questions coming up here.
Okay.
Yeah. Working model of Apple Boat was shown by username 9. I don't know who is that. And you are showing the working model of an Apple Boat. You can always post it on our Facebook and we'll be very happy to put it up there.
Yes, put the name and the age.
Bangalore, you know, the Green School Bangalore Facebook. So you understood what Aparupa was trying to do. She was connecting the seamlessly all the subjects together through science, technology, engineering, art, and mathematics. And probably she also
Somebody has a question.
Cooking without fire. Somebody is asking you a question. What is the acronym for MESS?
It is multiple intelligence. E stands for
energy that you use in using those multiple intelligence, your enthusiasm. Okay, Nandini ma'am, can you just share it? Explore and enjoy. She's sharing the screen with you for the mess.
And Archana Chatterjee says,
can an acronym, by the way. It is nowhere.
Yeah. And she says, Archana Chatterjee says, can you please tell the ascending and descending related to apple cutting? I missed that portion. And I must tell
you,
we have this on the Facebook Live. And you can go there and see. It's been recorded there. Whatever activities Aprupa has been doing it, it's there very much on the Facebook.
Okay, that's what MES stands for. M for multiple intelligence. E, explore and enjoy the 9 multiple intelligence. Use simple resources. I just used an apple, right from my toddler to adults. All of you can use it for different things. Keep the safety aspects because we used knife and things like that. So parental guidance, teacher guidance is required in certain places. And all of this is done to get those 1 hour of stress-free. I hope you know you all were stress-free and enjoying it.
Aprupa, there's a question for you. They're saying how to register for the next workshop.
That ma'am and Usha ma'am will take care.
Yeah, Manju Chakravarti, can you just tell them how to register for the next workshop? That's what the question is. Says fantastic workshop. Janavi says thank you so much, and then we've got Dhavan Joshi saying then super workshop. Thank you for sure. Thank you for this workshop. We enjoyed it. Thank you. Wonderful session. And Janavi says yep, an apple was used for the whole workshop and so many concepts covered. That was amazing. So everybody has been thanking you, Aprupa. I think there's a lot of thank you messages. And
thank you so much.
So much for being patient, audience.
Can you see the link which Manju has sent? And that link is the one for the next workshop. So you can use that link for all the 12 workshops which Aprupa will be doing. I think it was a fantastic workshop, Aprupa. I enjoyed it.
Thank you so much.
And I think next time I will be ready with a lot of things we'll be doing along with all of you. Okay,
yes.
Let's all do it again.
Don't worry. You all don't have to, you know, go anywhere. And I'm not going to tell you what in terms of resources for the workshop, because it's all available there, because we're going to use things which are simple, easily available, and can be done on spot. So wait for Saturday, something interesting cooking up to steam you all up. Till then, mess around. Bye-bye.
Thursday. Are they meeting on Thursday?
No, ma'am. On a Saturday. Thursday, there is something else that is planned. So, you know, I have.
So we have a Saturday. We have the coming workshop, as she said.
Yes.
And the topic is again about the DIY. But again, she said it's a surprise. So let's on Saturday, same time, tune in at 4 p.m. And we'll see you on which date is it, Aprupa? I think it is
23rd.
Yeah.
23rd, ma'am,
yes,
if 23rd. I'm not mistaken.
Yes. So 23rd Saturday at 4 p.m. Let's meet on Zoom. And we'll also be live on the Facebook. So thank you, Nandini. Thank you, Manju Chakravarti. And thank you, Priyanka, for making such a beautiful apple boat. And if somebody else who had apple boat and had not posted, please post it on the Facebook. So we'll be expecting you to write questions to us. We'll email the mail ID to you shortly. Manju Chakravarti will do, and you can post a lot of things, and Aprupa will be able to answer you for that. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, kiddos, and thank you, parents, for listening to all of us. And I hope you all enjoy this workshop.
Thank you. Bye.